in this type of errors where the trial balance has been prepared, again, there are different stages of errors. The first type of errors that we will explore here are called the two-sided errors, or also called errors which affect two or more accounts. That means those errors which are revealed by the trial balance, which are disclosed by the trial balance. So the errors, girls, which affect two accounts simultaneously, as one account has been wrongly debited and the other account has been wrongly credited. These type of errors are called the two-sided errors or the dual errors. So errors which have two or more than two places of their commission. The first type of error here, you can see here, it can be because of a complete omission of the, these are the four reasons how the two-sided errors can happen. What can lead to the two-sided errors? Either the error is of complete omission. That means I have passed, the transaction has been done, the goods have been purchased, goods have been sold, machinery has been purchased, furniture has been sold, any transaction, XYZ, any transaction has happened and it has completely been omitted to be recorded, neither debited nor credited. That is one blunder error that has happened, neither debited but nor credited. But besides this blunder, the trial balance goes on tallying. It will not be revealed in the trial balance. Why so? Because the amount neither has gone on the debit side nor on the credit side. Then comes the error, the type of errors of recording. We'll discuss in detail. Then there are errors of principle and errors posting to wrong account or with the wrong amount. These are the types of errors. Now see here, first I've given you the example. Supposing, for example, machinery, the transaction here says machinery purchased for rupees 10,000. The machinery purchased for 10,000. The correct entry for this has to be machinery account debited to cash account, rupees 10,000. Right? You agree with this? But in a hurry, accountant made a mistake with all the goods entries before that. He was recording purchases, debited, purchases to cash, purchases to this, purchases to Ravi, purchases to Sohan. And in the wake of so many purchases being debited, he debited purchases in machinery, the buying of the machinery. Now, purchases means the purchase of goods. But purchase of machinery is an asset. It should not go to purchase account. It should go to machinery account. But the error has happened. Now what? I cannot strike it. I cannot circle it or overwrite purchases in place of the machinery, in place of purchases. I cannot do it. Now what is the procedure? One way to do it is you will reverse what has been wrongly done. You see here, purchases has been debited. Debit the account. Now listen to the words. The steps are debit the account which has to be, see here I am doing the rectification entry. Debit the account which needs to be debited. Machinery has to be debited, has not been debited. So we will debit it now. Machinery account. And credit the account which has been wrongly debited. This purchase account has been wrongly debited. So I will nullify it by crediting it now. Two purchases. So the entry becomes machinery account, two purchases account, and the error is removed. See, the trial balance will see machinery on the debit side now, and the trial balance will also see purchases on the credit side, which will nullify the effect of debit purchases. One way to rectify this error is through this mechanism: debiting what needs to be debited and crediting what has been wrongly debited. Or another way, a shortcut way to the marks are for the rectification entry. And the steps to show the rectification entry, you can choose any of the procedure to show the rectification process. See, here I passed the correct entry, machinery to cash account. Wrong entry, purchases to cash account. I will now, as the rectifying procedure, I will reverse the wrong entry. Reversing means cash account debited to purchase account. Here I write here, cash to purchases. See, you can see here the correct entry. Now compare the correct entry and the reverse wrong entry. Machinery to cash, cash to purchases. Cash has been debited, cash has been credited. I will cancel the two accounts which are debited and credited in both the entries. The like accounts. What is the left? The residual accounts left are machinery debited, purchases credited. And that is what the rectification entry is. Machinery debited and purchases credited. Both the processes, both the methods of rectifying the entry will lead to the same result. Rectification entry in both the ways, both the methods will be same. You are free to choose any, but whatever you choose, do it completely. And it will not be entertained that you keep switching on to the two different methods in each entry. One question will have about 8 transactions of rectification. All 8 have to be pursued with any of the two methods. You cannot solve each transaction with a different method. So choose any, but let that one method stay for the solution of the whole question. Okay, now we'll switch over to the next type of errors and the rectification of next type of error.